Hello, Sim Gamers. We're diving into episode 2 of the Navigator's Guide to Sailwind. Sailwind is a game available on Steam Early Access. Link in the description below. Navigation in Sailwind uses devices and techniques found in the real world during the Golden Age of Sail. In this guide, we're looking at the Sun Compass, the second navigation instrument most sailors will be able to afford. Before we get into it, remember to hit that like button if you want to see more in-depth guides like these for Sailwind. Here's what the in-game navigation manual has to say about the Sun Compass. The Sun Compass can be used to determine your current latitude, north-south, by measuring the length of the shadow cast by the sun. Keep the compass level and wait until it stops rotating. The shadow of the needle on the face of the compass will point to your current latitude. Based on this, we learn that the Sun Compass is primarily used during the day to find our latitude by reading where the tip of the shadow falls. Let's try it out. I like to take these readings closer to noon, between 1100 hours and 1300 hours, because it's easiest to read. Another reason to do it near noon is to group other advanced readings in conjunction with this one that we'll go over later on in this guide. Based on the shadow, it looks like I'm at 31 degrees latitude, which is right since I'm reading this from Gold Rock City. Keep in mind, the Sun Compass is more accurate than the quadrant at daytime because of the precision of the shadow when compared to the fuzziness of the sun through the quadrant's sights. As you can see, the Sun Compass is a pretty straightforward instrument that also acts as an upgrade to the standard compass. Although, I prefer the markings on the standard compass for more accurate headings. Seems easy enough, but if you've seen my previous navigator's guide using the quadrant, we're not stopping at what's in the manual. Stick around for more advanced readings available by combining the Sun Compass with the chronometer. Hi, Sim Editor here. Video guides like these take considerable time and effort to make. If you want to see more guides like these, consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks! Determining our latitude is dirt simple during the daytime with the Sun Compass, but this instrument can also be used to determine our longitude. The basis for this use is the fact that the Sun Compass also has a sundial which tells us when it's precisely local noon. That is, the sun is directly to the south of us. When the shadow overlaps with the north-south line, it's precisely noon local time. The difference in time from our local noon to, say, Astron local time is how we can find our longitude. There are two instruments in Sailwind that tell time, and both of them are always set to Astron local time, the chronometer and the chrono compass. All chronometers are set to Astron time. That is, the chronometer reads noon when the sun is directly south of Astron. Because the chronometer always reads Astron time, we can use the time difference compared to local noon, when the sun is directly south of us, to figure out our longitude. Let's see it in action. Before local noon, take out the Sun Compass and watch for the shadow to fall directly over the north-south line. Personally, I like to face south for this particular measurement. Once the shadow hits noon across the north-south line, switch to the chronometer and look at the time. Based on which side of noon our time falls, we are either east or west of longitude zero. Times before 1200 hours indicates we are east of longitude zero, closer to the Emerald Archipelago side of the map, because the sun rises in the east. Times after 1200 hours indicates we are west of zero, closer to Al-Ankh, because the sun sets in the west. Now that we have the time, we need to convert the time difference into longitude. Every 4 minutes of difference is equal to 1 degree of longitude. In my case, I got 1220. 20 minutes past noon means I'm in negative degrees, aka more westward. Dividing 20 minutes by 4 minutes per degree gives me negative 5 degrees, which is correct as I'm in Gold Rock City. Notably, the Sun Compass and chronometer can only be combined at local noon to get our longitude. So I like to take both my daytime longitude and latitude readings around noon for efficiency. Although the quadrant at night provides highly accurate latitude readings, The sun compass is more accurate than the quadrant at noon for determining our latitude. Also, the sun compass at noon is more accurate than the quadrant at night for longitude because the quadrant is extremely time sensitive and the readout is less precise for accurate measurements. Whereas the sun compass very accurately tells us when it's local noon, and the chronometer is the most accurate instrument for reading the time based in Eastern time. In conclusion, with the sun compass and chronometer in hand, this knowledge opens up the wide seas for adventure. Now we can go wherever we want with confidence because we have the tools to locate our precise latitude during the day and find our longitude at noon if we combine it with the chronometer. In the next guide, we're covering the many uses of the chrono compass, the end-game navigation instrument. Until then, I am Sim Gamer, and this has been the Navigator's Guide to Sailwind. Goodbye!